First World Order Radio, finally, we are on the air, no doubt. All right.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns and existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the same as your thoughts transmits it. Burn. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns and existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. Order. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages for us to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories. Shit that works.
Right, peace. First of all, the radio, we back.
Peace, Dr. Aline.
Peace, how you doing?
Wonderful.
I want to read this passage. It's coming from the autobiography of a yogi by Yogananda, in which he breaks down the Kundalini. And, you know, I just want to add this as part of, you know, as the show. And basically, he was saying Genesis is deeply symbolic. He said Genesis is deeply symbolic and cannot be grasped by literal interpretation. He explains its tree of life is the human body. The spinal cord is like the upturned tree with the hair as its roots,
right?
And the nerves as its branches. The tree of the nervous system bears many enjoyable fruits or sensations of sight, sound, smell, taste, and touch. In these, man may rightfully indulge, but he was forbidden the experience of sex, the apple at the center of the body, which is in the midst of the garden. So the serpent represents the coiled up spinal column that stimulates the sex nerves. Adam is reason, is feeling. With the emotions of ease, consciousness in any human being is overpowered by the sex impulse, his reason or Adam is also succumbed. God created the human species by materializing the bodies of man and woman through the force of his will. He endowed the new species with the power to create children in a similar immaculate or divine manner. Because its manifestations in the individual soul have hereto limits to animals, instincts bound, and lack the potentiality of full reason, God made the first human beings, the symbolic called Adam and Eve. To these, the advantages of upward evolution began. He transferred the soul and the divine essence of two animals in Adam, or man, which is reason, predominant, and in Eve, or woman, feelings, was ascended. Thus was expressed as the duality or polarity that underlies the phenomenal worlds. Reason and feeling remains in a heaven of cooperative joy as so long as the human mind is not tricked by the serpentine energy of animal propensity. The human body was therefore not solely a result of evolution from animals or beasts, but was produced through an act of special creation by God. The animal form was too crude to express full divinity. Man was uniquely given the potentiality of omniscient, which is the thousand-petaled lotus in the brain, as well as acutely awakening occult centers in the spine.
Mm.
All right, so that's part of what it was going into. I just wanted to start that off, and I know you're going to want to blow us away, dog. So
definitely go through it. Real interesting, and they do, and it's interesting too. We're gonna get into that where they talk about the difference between man and animal, man's upright spine versus animal's horizontal spine, and in terms of its tree, whereas you differentiate between something that was just fucked into being is something brought into being. You get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So that upright man, we're going to get into the representation of that and what it means in the context of Kundalini and gravity and all the rest of that stuff. But, you know, we want to get a little bit of information out of the way before we get into the study, which is, I had a long conversation with Bobby today, which was very interesting.
Yeah.
Now, you hadn't heard me speak too much on it because, be honest with you, shit looked real bleak when I went up there, you know, when he first had his stroke. In every human sense of the word, there was nothing short of a miracle if he was going to get up again, you know. Of course, you know, we understand the spiritual context of it. But he has full brain capacity, and really the only thing that's left, and really that's a very small obstacle, is the physical work that needs to be done. So let me point out, and this is his words, what's been really helping him is that little help fund that everyone was chipping in. Him and Linda has been receiving that money. That's all legit. The people who handle that is Kali and Mama Congo. Y'all know it's Sandra Fraser and Jerry Miller. He has been getting every single thing you guys have been giving. Fortunately, he still needs more shit. He needs this equipment for his rehabilitation. So if you gave, you know, and he really does talk about how he's appreciating it. You know, if you're able to help out more, you know, it's always nice because he has to get, like, ramps and shit like that. But, like I said, the good news is his capacity, his mind capacity, which is what they were nervous about, is at 100%. This nigga's still fucking funny as shit. You know what I'm saying? You know, he's in I love you man mode, so everything is he loves you. And he said, you know, he was telling me about some of the shit that was happening. So when he's at full strength, I'm sure he's going to want to talk about it himself. You know, some of the gods that were coming through. He gave me a few gods. One of the gods he did say give out, and I wrote it down, was a god that made contact with him, an ancestral god. He said we can use to help knock out depression called Ogugu. That's how he pronounced it, Ogugu. And he said he made contact with this guy when he kept telling me, oh, man, Pan, I was on these fucking demands. This nigga's mind is it. The first thing he get on the phone and said was, what channels did you get? I'm like, damn, nigga, you all about business, nigga.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I told him some things that came through, and he started telling me some of the shit that was happening. And basically he said C. Freeman L. came through. If y'all don't know who C. Freeman L. is, you should be ashamed of yourself, but that was one of Bobby's first teachers. And one, you know, he's a teacher well known in our metaphysical thing. One of the, and you know, a real advanced yogi, you know, one a real advanced Moorish yogi. And nevertheless, C. Freeman L. came through and helped him with a lot. He said, along with some others, but he said there's an ancestral deity named Ogugu. He said. The presence of angels, the angelic forces, which he was dealing with heavily, came through very strong. I did a reading for someone this week. Some of the angels, interesting some of the angels that came up for this person were some of the angels he was calling up, Metatron, Cassiel, Raphael. He said all of these guys came through. So he's in very high spirits, very, very amazing. And like I said, give to his little help fund. That shit is more helpful than you know. I know he's very appreciative of everyone who came through and donated. He was very surprised that he got that type of attention. So if you don't know where to give, just contact me at panicpack@hotmail.com, and I'll send you the links, or I'll hook you up with the people who are taking care of that. Or if you're already on Facebook, they put the link up often in my group. Kali does that, and so you should be in my group anyway. So, like I said, I can tell you about 1,000 things this nigga was talking about. But like I said, you know, from the beginning, Linda didn't want me to speak too much on what was really going on in detail. But now that she has an update, you know, it's all good. You know, now that she has an update, it's all good. So, like I said, he's damn near 100%, except for the physical portion. You know, he still needs to do the physical. But his brain is there. This nigga talking about, you know, still dropping science. You know, 10 years ago, Luther Vandross had a stroke, and to the day I had one, on point, knows his shit. And, oh, one more thing. I don't have a hookup out here with bootleg CDs. He's bootleg CD man. So anybody who has a hookup with good bootleg CDs, let me know, because he needs to catch up with some of these fucking movies. That Superman movie and all that kind of shit, we were talking about that. So I don't have a hookup out here. So anybody who has a hookup, just email me at PattingPack. And if you need some cash to give me a few of the newer DVDs, just go ahead and email me. All right, so I just wanted to get that out the way. Let everybody have an update on Brother Bobby, and we're going to get down to some science.
I appreciate it more.
All right. Now, first thing we need to understand is about Kundalini energy, because what we've been doing here on First World Radio is cutting through the bullshit. Cutting through the bullshit is our theme. You know, we are no longer playing cutesy with this shit. And my goal, as with many of the master teachers' goals or the guys who call themselves dedicated to teaching folks, whatever title you want to add, has always been to cut down the bullshit. Mm-hmm. So one of the things that stands out as a true... Your true work in consciousness, everything else is fluffy, is really Kundalini enlightenment. If you can narrow down to what it is you're doing to Kundalini enlightenment, and you'll see why based upon some of the Kundalini statements that I've accumulated through time, it seems to be all about this process of raising Kundalini, this enlightenment that comes from this process that takes you out of your human condition. Ultimately, consciousness is not to be shared with your humanity. The point of being conscious, in I say conscious loosely, the point, because you're really supposed to be doing the alchemy. You're really supposed to be transforming. You need to be conscious to be able to take those steps. So technically, just being conscious is not enough. Being conscious is just saying you're aware that something is rotten, something's wrong, right. Something's not normal. That's really what consciousness is. But consciousness is a blanket way of trying to label a people or a mindset. But really all it is the beginning point of you beginning to study. So someone saying you're conscious does not mean you have automatically cross over into enlightenment. So consciousness does not equal enlightenment. Consciousness makes you aware. And right. You're only aware that you're not actually just a mindless zombie human. So So when you'll hear me talking about humanity and you try to champion this human cause and trees and bees, the mere fact that you say you're conscious is a contradiction, because the idea of consciousness is to say you are no longer participating in what the mindless, everyday minutia, the routine that everyone else is doing. You are no longer thinking as easy and as less complex and as whatever's put in front of you as the average person. Why? Because you're conscious. So consciousness is step one in starting to find enlightenment. So if we had to label or narrow down what the process of finding enlightenment is, don't get confused. It's not one way to find enlightenment. Knowledge is endless. Therefore, there are endless ways to find enlightenment. But the only thing that must hold true is you must be searching for enlightenment. And the idea is you didn't find it as a human. Therefore, you are searching in other advanced places. You have a faith or a belief or understanding there's something greater than you that walks around, or that's in you, that something's greater than you then walks around and experiences just this world with five senses. Five senses or your ego represents humanity. Therefore, if you're conscious and you're seeking enlightenment, you're not seeking to perfect humanity. You're not seeking to perfect or enhance what it is that can be enhanced by the average Joe. You're trying to do something else. You're trying to do something that is not normally done. Just like Neo said in The Matrix, this works because it was never done before. There's titles for this. It's called The Left-Hand Path. It's called The Journey of the Hero. So there are titles for this. This isn't something I'm making up. This is an idea that is old as the beginning of time, stepping outside of the box. The problem is they think because we're in church and we're so exploited, if you do something African, which seems to be of a higher frequency than what's happening in America, that you have somehow made it or you have somehow went to the next level. But even in the time where Africans reign supreme, the person who stepped outside of the box then would still be considered the alchemist, would still be considered the conscious person if everybody else was doing African shit. So it's not even about a traditional group setting or a traditional setting of this versus that. It's about the individual stepping out of the group and coming up with his own interpretation, coming up with his own experiment, becoming the scientific mind, the scientist mentality, to come up with forms of light for your own personal transformation. And becoming the example of it is how you help others, as opposed to this agenda of helping others, which is nothing more than just some cultural, traditional, wheezy from the help center shit. So if you had to narrow this down, or this process down, or this understanding of enlightenment down, Kundalini is the thing that comes up constantly. Kundalini, enlightenment, is the what it always seems to come down to. So we're going to deal with some statements. I'm going to go through some notes. Some of these Kundalini things. Hendrik Zimmerman. This is something Hendrik Zimmerman observed. The best things can't be told. The second best are misunderstood. So basically, what I find is people's understanding of a lot of these terms we use are misunderstood. Because what's happening is they're taking these advanced terms, as I just laid it out, that these things are supposed to be understood so you can go on a otherworldly adventure, or an adventure that's outside of the normal, routine, the normal, everyday interpretation of planet Earth. So the Kundalini experience that you're supposed to have is not one where you say, well, I was eating a sandwich and I had a Kundalini experience. I got some good old pussy and had a Kundalini experience. I was sleeping and had a Kundalini experience. Those things can happen. Those things will happen. But ultimately, they're like anything, there are levels, and you're trying to have this Kundalini experience to go beyond the norm. So the best things can't be told. So that means someone who's telling, when you're in my group asking, well, what does this feel like? And what does that feel like? No one can tell you that. You're going to have to do some work, because the best of what this is cannot be told to you. So when you're trying to figure out panic, why is this, and do you do that panic, and do you do this panic? If I did that or didn't do that, it doesn't matter, because you will not have the experience until you try it. So it cannot be told to you. And then again, if you don't understand these terms or have a clear understanding on the goal, you will misunderstand what this shit is about. Now, in earlier times, when esoteric knowledge was under jealous guard, and the spiritual aspirant usually had to endure years of patient waiting before he was taught. Now that information is available basically everywhere: books, tapes, CDs, online. Secret doctrines can now be purchase and easily possess. It does not mean they are easily comprehended, though they can be easily possessed. The words can be taught, sold, and the living wisdom cannot be confined within words, but still must be earned. Still must be earned. So, in other words, watching YouTube, buying a nice book collection from Amazon is not going to do it for you. It's not going to do it for you. This is a Kundalini, raising Kundalini, dealing with Kundalini is a process. It's not an overnight thing. It's not a destination. It is the primal energy in you, and it is always renewed, always changing. It is always life force. It is always will have a new meaning depending on what it is you're dealing with and why it is you're doing this particular work. So, again, you've heard me talk to you before about agenda, and you having this agenda, and you doing things for your agenda, you can never go further than your agenda.
Mm-hmm.
This is the same thing as having a religion or a group. The group is a group based upon the rules of the group, and if you do ungroup shit, you are no longer in the group. If you do shit that's against the religion, you are no longer a religious person.
Exactly.
Therefore, you are limited by its very nature. So, for most people who are conscious, or who call themselves conscious, they have given up their religion. Perhaps some have given up their group, but they have traded it in for an agenda, for a goal, and. What I've come to learn that your goal should be no goal. The only goal that it is to actually understand that there is no goal. That knowledge, again, is endless, boundless, and therefore cannot be constrained by definition, religion, grouping, or names. Once you start to, mind you, I'm explaining this to you so you can try to adapt a mentality to begin your study, to dealing with your study. So it's easy to get these things. There was a time, again, this was jealous guard. This was guarded with zeal and jealousy. But how come you think it's all on the web now? How come you think no one's, this Illuminati or whoever the fuck you believe is controlling you, hasn't stopped this now? Because they understand, if you do not understand it, if you do not comprehend the wisdom, mm-hmm. in the way it should be comprehended, then it's worthless. I don't care how much melanin you got. If you don't know how to exact it, then it's worthless. Worthless. No matter if you know all the lingo, Hotep, no matter how many times you said Hotep, it makes you no more magical. No more magical. We need to adopt the understanding or the mentality. That's what I find after all of these years of talking and interfacing with people. We have not. We just don't understand the mentality that it takes for us to even begin our process. Forget what it is we're learning, because the knowledge is everywhere. That's not hard to figure it out. Real secrets are secrets because no one understands them. That's
exactly.
What makes them a secret.
Right.
That's what makes them a secret. It's not you're getting secret information because it's on YouTube and Panic said it or Bobby said it or Brother Aleem said it.
Mm-hmm.
That's not secret information. The real secret is you don't understand it. That's what makes it a secret.
Mm-hmm.
One cannot even talk about them or even such a kind of experience if you're dealing with Kundalini, because these secrets will be revealed because you're having a first-hand experience with the light. You get what I'm saying? Kundalini is the source of all your experiences. Kundalini is that indwelling energy by which self-identifying with your options and characteristics, traits, preserves your identity, and it preserves your identity. Basically, it is who you are. It is who you are. When you start dealing with this Kundalini energy, or you know you're supposed to be raising Kundalini, and we'll get into some techniques, and I'm sure Aleem has plenty as well.
Right.
What you're doing is you're interfacing with yourself. It's called Know Thyself. Not know thy what George Zimmerman the fuck is doing. You get what I'm saying? Or not doing. All right. Okay. Humanity makes you who you are now. Kundalini makes you into what you will become. So, let's be clear on this. Dealing with this work is trying to explain to you, conscious folks, that you're trying to become something. See, I don't think we understand. We revel in this melanin. We revel in what we have done already as pyramid builders, as Angkor Wat builders. We kind of blow up our ego saying we're better than you because we were the first, this, that, the other. But you would not be down here unless you still was trying to continue transformation, period. So therefore, you have to first accept you're still becoming something. Again, I've always given this example. Eddie Murphy coming to America, he was the prince, and he was destined to be the king. But he still went to McDonald's, to church, to find Lisa, which represented alchemy or a new love or becoming something new. You get what I'm saying? It's the same concept. Now, what you are as a human, we won't even have to get into this wretchedness of it all. But we
mm-hmm.
will say this: you have been a human for quite a long time. So before you even get into the wretchedness of human being, if you cannot stomach that, what you need to understand is it's something that you've done already. So it's not like you hate the third grade, but you've already passed the third grade. Just look at it that way.
Mm-hmm.
If you cannot understand the Gnostic understanding, which is really all the understandings, the Gnostics just said it straight out. But really, if you use your common sense, if you read anything about Kemetic mythology and all the Kemetic people, their entire goal was to leave the planet and never come back. So indirectly, they're saying, fuck this place. It's not the hot shit. You get what I'm saying? There's no hieroglyph that tells you about diet, you know what I'm saying, health care in the future, job searching, what to do with George Zimmerman, none of that. All the hieroglyphs talk about leaving and never coming back. So later day Egyptians, called the Coptic Egyptians, which were the Gnostics, basically said, well, we're going to take away all the fluff. We don't
mm-hmm.
have time for temples and initiations and
mm-hmm.
and breeding you here. So we're going to just take away all the fluff, come tell you a doctrine what they were talking about and came up with the Gnostic mythology that we know today, the Demiurge, Yal Dabaoth, and so on and so forth. But basically what they talked about was the wretchedness of humanity, how it's you better off being a bum on the other side than a king on this side, that the human body is nothing but a cesspool, a septic tank, that this is the bastardized crazy. You can go on, I'm going on and on for days of not my interpretation, the ancient Gnostic interpretation, which each time I give out those books in class, somebody's finding light like they've never found light, and starts to make sense to them because they understand there's something in them that understands this. There's something ancient in you that understands this concept. You were mind-controlled into believing this is the best you got. This is the best we've got. This is you're this human-centered being, and the universe somehow revolves around you. You get what I'm saying? You're just one grain of sand in one particular beach out in the middle of fucking nowhere called Earth. You're not that special. You get what I'm saying? What it is, but you were born with what they call divine spark, or that light which you can turn into a roaring flame, and this is represented as your soul. And this is done through alchemy. This is done through self-transformation. You have to save your motherfucking self. There's no group that can save you. There's no entity that's going to save you.
Right.
Entities are nothing but energies that are designed by you, FUBU, for us, by us, for us to utilize for the sake of alchemy, for the sake of energy that we can use for whatever cause we want. Now, I hope it's a higher fucking cause than just getting your laundry done. All right, let's see. What else we got? Let me see. Next page. Tantra is not book knowledge. It's living wisdom, which must be obtained directly from an experienced practitioner. Meaning you cannot talk this out, you cannot theorize this out. Unless you're into the practices, you're not into shit. So your books cannot save you. Unless you're into the practices, you're not into shit. So you're going to have to find a book for practice. Not a book in theory to drop your science on Kundalini, none of that. You're going to have to get into some form of a practice. And listen closely. Let me explain what a practice is. It's not necessarily something that has a title. It may be something you make up tomorrow down at fucking Walmart. But it needs to be something active that you need to engage yourself visually, because through visualization is probably, I would have to say, 85% of what it is you need to do. Einstein's statement, and I'm paraphrasing, was visualization is far more valuable than intelligence. Visualization is far more valuable than intelligence because you have to be able to see these things for anything to materialize. So you need to find some sort of visualization to see yourself. In fact, Linda said for Bobby, what she's been playing Breaking Dawn over and over. There's a scene where the girl starts transforming herself. I don't watch that series, but there's a scene where the girl transforms herself. He said she's been playing that over and over. And he said the nigga woke up and told her thank you. Because he said he was able to hold on to that shit in the spirit world and was able to visualize and wake himself up. Now, let me be clear on this. On the human side, the doctors are baffled at the type of stroke that he had. Like I said, a lot of that nobody really spoke on that. The type of stroke that he had, if I was a regular human, you would look at him and say it's a miracle that he's up and aware.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Compared to the type of stroke he had. And And basically, she said she, and the shit was funny because I went to the hospital the second day he was in there, and you know, he was sedated, gone, and that's where I met his brother. And when I'm talking to him today, I was like, yeah, I met your brother. He remembered that shit. He's like, yeah, you met my oldest brother. So this nigga was there when he was knocked out. This, the shit I was saying to the nigga when he was out, the nigga was answering that shit now. So shit is serious. You know what I'm saying? That's a powerful nigga. I got to give him his props. A powerless or ignorant guru is far worse than none at all. So basically, half you niggas walking around talking that Hotep shit are actually worse off than people who go to church every week.
Exactly.
Worse off because you think you know some shit. You know what I'm saying? And you ain't going to fool me because I've got some veterans who have come to my class and, let me say this, humble enough to take a class, and you know, you got a few. I've been doing this for since I was a teenager, and they still humble enough to say later on, "Wow, what I've learned still has managed to change my life and this and that." Now they have to be humble if they're going to take a class in the first place. So they have to admit to themselves that there's something that they want to learn or need to learn or at least try to learn with me. But there's these motherfucking gurus that know absolutely fucking nothing. So a powerless or ignorant guru is far worse than none at all.
Right.
Kundalini summarized the path of an occultist or the journeysman. Follow in his or her odyssey from the darkness or unexamined mundane existence to the light of celestial realms, all maintaining consciousness of both. See, what they're talking about here is, yet again, understanding this, they represent humanity as this darkness and ignorance, and truth, the path of Kundalini is truly finding your bliss or celestial light. And while you do this, what I notice is people tend, well, fuck Earth, fuck Earth. Earth sucks, fuck Earth. No, Earth sucks and fuck all of that, and yeah, yeah, but you need to be conscious of what exactly it is. You need to be conscious, and that's another way of saying you need to be conscious of your ego. You get what I'm saying? Not, see, most people are under this idea that you're supposed to be destroying your ego. And your ego is actually what clothes you here in this imaginary world. It is what you need to survive. You get what I'm saying? You cannot get out of this, you have to navigate through this world with some form of illusionary clothes. And that is represented as a personality. Most of our personalities were built up for us. Most of our personalities were created by our parents or whomever. So the goal, so it's not like you're trying to defeat that because you need it to operate. That's what you do when you pay your bills, drive your car to work, or whatever the fuck it is you got to do. But it's not about defeating it as much as it's becoming aware of it. Not necessarily celebrating it, but coming aware of being aware of where it belongs. So this is what is meant by is you be conscious of both. You need to be conscious and understand the difference of divine love, of true heart chakra compassion. See, you see this online a lot. Oh, queen, peace queen, your special queen. And it'd be a dumb chick, and they're just saying it because she's a woman. And they're somehow in their mind believing they're doing something with the heart chakra or raising up the divine feminine when this girl could be saying something idiotic. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And it has nothing to do with the divine feminine or your respect for women, this particular girl may be an idiot. You get what I'm saying?
Right.
But somehow we've come to, oh, queen and queen, queen over everything, as if this is a display of the heart chakra, right? This tells me you're not conscious or you're closing your mind to reality. You're either under mind control, you're trying too fucking hard, or you're just fucking stupid. You get what I'm saying? Really, in the occult, they say you just went crazy. And you went crazy with poisoning because you have studied this. They'll say, well, you study the occult, you might go crazy. Well, they're not talking about you standing outside, you know what I'm saying, talking to a fire hydrant. What they're talking about is your thoughts are no longer your own. You get what I'm saying? If everyone's saying, you know, you ever see somebody start saying Hotep and they don't even know what the fuck that shit means? Oh, Hotep goddess. It's like, motherfucker, you don't go home and say that shit. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not going to say it to you. Like, I want to give a shout out to my boy Will. Will, you know, I'm in Atlanta. I don't know how to drive. So my man Will was like, look, dude, I just quit my job. I'm trying to, I'll find out what he's trying to do. Maybe we can help out. He's trying to do some internet shit. He's like, shit, nigga, we'll hang out and drive and all that. I met his queen. She came up to me and said, I almost said Hotep to your ass. I said, shit, you would have never heard the end of that. You know what I'm saying? And it's like you just get used to saying these type of stuff and saying these things. If that's who you are, that's who you are. No judgment. You get what I'm saying? But we're talking about the people who say it to get on the bandwagon. You get what I'm saying? To get on the bandwagon. And really, that's the epitome of religious thought. You know what I'm saying? Someone say hallelujah, you say hallelujah. They say amen, you say amen. They say Hotep, you say Hotep. Knowing damn well you ain't a Hotep nigga. And I think I've said this before, but one of the most profound things I've heard was Slick Rick. Slick Rick said he said this shit somewhere on the radio years ago when it mattered what Slick Rick had to say. He said he basically said everybody who's in hip hop is fronting at the very core. He said it's just a matter of how hard they're going to front. He said, because not one person stands in front of their mother and goes, yeah, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Can you feel me? You don't do that to your moms, because your moms go, what the fuck is wrong with you, Sherman? But she knows who you are. So that means you do that shit on the street, which means it's a front by nature because you don't act like that 24 hours.
Exactly.
And you know goddamn well you don't go around your moms and go Hotep, Urigani, and all the rest of that bullshit. You save it in this circle. You know what I'm saying? You save it for this circle. Now, I'm not saying nothing's wrong with it at its fundamental nature, but you know when the motherfucker is fronting. And the idea here for true conscious enlightenment is you're trying to get away from the fronting. You're trying to get away. You fundamentally ask the question, who am I? What am I? Because I know I'm not panic. You get what I'm saying? I know I'm not five senses. You get what I'm saying? I know I must be more. So it's not like you trying to confess to the world a certain amount of reality, but you at least confessing to yourself a certain amount of reality, what you can and cannot do, what you won't and will not do, and what you'll say and won't say. I'm not going to say Hotep in front of my goddamn aunties, so I'm not going to say it in front of you. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? If I was a Hotep nigga, I'm going to be a Hotep nigga. If I'm not a Hotep nigga, I'm not going to be a part-time Hotep nigga. You get what I'm saying? Because the idea here is you at least need to start dealing with some reality that's at least within yourself. You know what I'm saying? Only after passing through the valley of the shadow of death do we learn how to live. Now, that's a very profound statement, because through Kundalini enlightenment, what you do is they call it the shadow of death, which is actually, you can look at it as melanin, or you could look, but what's really happening is the same comedic thing. The Kamites taught death. You would almost say they was obsessed with death, even to their children. When there was no death, or they passed through the shadow of death, they feared no evil, and life became a cinch. Because you got to think about in your psyche. In your psyche, every single thing we do every single move we make is all, every single movie we watch, every single thing we do is trying to avoid death. First of all, the inevitable. Why? Not because life is so grand and shit is going well. It's because of fear. It's fundamentally because of fear. And with that being said, if you need to face that fear within yourself. How you do it is up to you. We're not talking about being suicidal. We're not talking about trying to die. You get what I'm saying?
Right.
We're talking about preparation for death. We're talking about preparing for the inevitable or come to terms with your time. You get what I'm saying? And see, we do that shit like we do our half a hotel. You know what I'm saying? When shit is working for us, it's the laws of attraction. It's how things are supposed to be. It's our path. When they let George Zimmerman off, it's a fucking tragedy, a travesty, and that boy died too soon and shit. You know what I'm saying? Sean Cook told me he was talking to somebody, and, you know, they all metaphysical, and that's their path, and my child chose me, and my child is here because my child chose me. Then, oh, no, look what they did to Trayvon. He said, well, didn't he choose death? What happened to all the laws of attraction and his path? Well, that's a different story. You know what I'm saying? Dude, that's a different story. You get what I'm saying?
Right.
It's like, you know, it's really just that amazing. You get what I'm saying? It's really just that amazing. And so we got to really be more about what it is we're claiming to be for us to be really effective in our transformation, in our true conscious path, in our true progress. You cannot see, you gotta remember this conscious enlightenment is something that happens with you. So it's not about you convincing me. I'm trying to tell you can't fool yourself. That's why you're going nowhere. Because you're trying to fool yourself. You're not really trying to fool me. And I've seen motherfuckers say all sorts of shit on my page and go to the next philosopher's page and say all the shit they like to hear. You get what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So this shit is not fooling me. You're fooling yourself. You
right.
Get what I'm saying? You're fooling yourself. And ultimately, this thing is truly and fundamentally about really self-reality. You get what I'm saying? This is about wiping away half the book. You got to remember, your whole theory on this planet is covering up bullshit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's covering up bullshit. Everything you say out your mouth is to protect your integrity. You know what I'm saying? You may like to eat cookies and milk naked. You know what I'm saying? If this ain't hotep enough, you ain't going to tell nobody. Let's be real. You know what I'm saying? You may like to, you know what I'm saying, wipe chocolate across your chest and run around the goddamn forest. Who the fuck knows? But you ain't going to announce that shit in no goddamn chat room. You know what I'm saying? I'm a chocolate forest runner. That's my thing. You know what I'm saying? Niggas going to say panicked and lost his fucking mind. Well, no, I get off on it. You know, Juno of the forest and all this kind of shit. And you would definitely be, you know, this nigga, you ain't going to tell nobody the half the shit you do. You know what I'm saying? Half the shit you ain't gonna tell nobody. It's just fucking weirdo shit. Only, you know what I'm saying? You ain't gonna tell nobody the type of porno you buy. You know what I'm saying?
No.
Granny porn and shit. You know, my name is Panic. I'm in the granny porn.
Granny
nigga.
Porn.
I'm in the granny porn, nigga. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? My name is Panic. I like midgets. You know what I mean? I like to watch midgets fuck. You know what I mean? Ain't nobody going to tell nobody that. But see what I'm saying? You need to be honest with yourself. You know what I'm saying? Fuck it, I like midgets. And what? You know what I'm saying? Grandma is doing it right now. You know what I'm saying? She still got a few hits left in her. You know what I'm saying? If that's your shit, it's your shit. You know what I'm saying? You have to buy porn and be all secretive about that shit. I could be buying porn and it was all secretive about that shit. I started announcing that shit. I got a garage full of porn. Now what? what you want? You know what I'm saying? College chicks. Because these like, The fuck is this? Black Teens number 44, nigga. You fucking pervert. I'm like, yo, look, they ain't real teens, nigga. They not real teens. Like, the motherfuckers look like teens to me, motherfucker. Like, they can't do that. That's a selling point. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I like amputee porn. You know what I'm saying? That's my shit. More stump hump in action. You know what I'm saying? More stump hump in action. So, like, you can't front on yourself. That's one thing I teach in class. Like, look, fuck it. It's not like I have to admit to you, but I have to admit to myself. You know, get on watch porn on you know, the sounds on, like, one. I turn my porn up. You know what I'm saying? Fuck it. Well, what? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, he, I'm admitting to myself. That's what it is. You know what I mean? Shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm off porn now, though. You know what I'm saying? I swear to you, like, when I was in New York, though, shit, man, oh, man. I threw away, like, at least $20,000 worth of porn before I got here. For real, I need a rehab. Religions are limited because they concentrate only on one aspect of truth. This is why they're always fighting amongst one another, because they all think they are in sole possession of the truth. But I say there's no end to knowledge, so there's no use in trying to combine it with scriptures or a holy book or down to one experience. So again, it's what we talked about. We have this problem, this problem with trying to pick one thing and ride that one thing until the wheels fall off. And that's probably one of our biggest problems. Compartmentalizing. We're in the best position. As I pointed out earlier, knowledge, there was a time where you had to go. If I wanted to study anything about Indus Kush, I had to go to that motherfucker. And then I would have to trek my ass to China to study anything there. And the type of study, the detail, would damn near take almost lifetime to deal with. We in the big melting pot era of this now, therefore, we have access to so much information. Now, a lot of this information is fragmented. A lot of this information is fragmented, and this is something Bobby Hemmett taught through the 90s. A lot of this conscious occult information is not complete. Therefore, you cannot deal with one thing and feel you're going to have a complete study. That's poppycock.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to have to get into the world of what they call correspondence, meaning, like, for instance, there's a book called Gods of Ecstasy, Gods of Love and Ecstasy. I think it's by Alan Dandelou. And basically, he talks about Dionysus and Shiva. And throughout the book, he draws this is a Greek god, which is our shit. These remember, I did a whole show on these gods of myth are nothing but energies, and their faces and names have changed depending on who's or what culture is telling the story, but they're based on our gods. And you can start from Sumeria and probably early before that, I'm sure, for those historians, Atlantean gods and so on and so forth. But those energies are primarily never changed, and even though they have new names, new dressing, new colors, new roles, updated roles and attributes, it's the same energies just reheated. So the Egyptian pantheon is nothing but another Negro pantheon. Please believe that. So Dionysus, which is just Dionysus, which is iron Isis, and iron is John, and John somehow is connected to Adam, and and still, I remember reading somewhere, it's still connected to Osiris. So Dionysus or Dionysus is still a mixture of Osiris and Isis. And basically, he's the grown-up version of Pan. And Shiva, of course, is another Osirian figure, but you can find much on Shiva. In this book, he puts them together, corresponding. So what you don't know about one, you can figure out about the other. And if you know they're both talking about Osiris, the very little information you have on Osiris, you can add and fill in the holes when you deal with Shiva or Dionysus or Hades or Obatala or any of these other father figures. So correspondence is the key, because you're going to have to, because none of these systems are fully put together. And so for that to happen, what that entails is you to think outside of the religious box that you were put into. This one path, this one clue. See, we got they exploiting this warrior shit. You know what I'm saying? We have this mentality where we need to pick a side, pick a group. You get what I'm saying? We never have this idea of that we can deal with it all. You get what I'm saying? You grow up in Compton, you got to yell, I'm from Compton. You go from the west side, I got to yell from the west side. You grow up a Crip, I'm a Crip. I'm a Blood. You got to pick something. That's all of that stems from a warrior mentality, which led up into a religious mentality, into a gangbanging mentality, and now it's also led to a fucking scholarly mentality. Pick a side. I'm a this, I'm a that. I believe in that. I'm all about that. Now, if that's what you are and you can't get out of that, I'm not addressing you. You are who you are, and you should be as religious as you need to be. I'm addressing those who claim to want to do the alchemy and so on and so forth, you know, who's trying to go to that next level. So it's the religious mentality that you must defeat, and you need to understand this. At the core of that is because, or what can bring you home or bring you through that, is the fact that we need to understand that knowledge is endless. Therefore, if you're doing the knowledge that you're supposed to be doing, then your study can become endless. I never run out of shit to study. Or could possibly study as long as I want to, because I understand it's endless. I can study the same shit I've been studying and find something new at a different time.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Because that's the mentality, right? That's the mentality I set myself up for. I didn't close my mind to one understanding of one line or one agenda. So if I read something with an agenda, that line will never leave that agenda. If I read something about Kundalini, thinking Kundalini is about drugs and drugs alone, then every single drug I take will be about Kundalini. I cannot escape that. You get what I'm saying? I put myself in a mental prison. When knowledge is endless, and what you are is endless, and what you are is that's the whole theory of what you're doing. That you are endless, boundless, formless. The beginning, the end, and so on and so forth. The human body is a vessel in which consciousness pours according to the individual's capacity. So your consciousness is up to you. Your consciousness is up to your capacity to become that vessel. Most, again, having this agenda or having this goddamn social etiquette shit, you know what I'm saying, shuts you down as a vessel. See, we think that this vessel is what it is that you are. You don't think of it as a vessel, as a tool, as an outfit for this particular reality to do work for a greater cause. We think that this is the fucking party. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You think that you at the motherfucking party right now. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You're not even dressed for the fucking occasion, it turns out. You're not even dressed for the occasion, you know what I'm saying? Or basically, you are dressed for the occasion. You got melanin. But you don't even know what the fucking party, you ain't got an invite, you know what I'm saying? You ain't got an invite. So this is not even a fragment of what it is you are. You're putting too much stock in it. Now, WMAP, I can't remember what it stands for, WMAP. What it does is, this is some shit that I got in my book, it mapped the universe. I think it was in the late 90s they did it. What they found out was 70% of the universe was dark energy, 25% was dark matter, and only 4%, let me say that again, 4% is physical matter, what you see. So that boundless universe that you look and you marvel about, with all these fucking stars and Osiris, is only 4% of your reality, which means it's not reality at all. We won't even get into that as a fucking hologram. But still, you're only witnessing 4%. The reality behind it is the dark mother and the dark father. If you're not communicating with that dark side of you, which is your dark parents, which is only really basically the parents to your conscious thought, which is your subconscious mind. The parents to your conscious thought is your subconscious mind. So if you're not dealing with your subconscious mind to bring it out of darkness into the light, you ain't doing shit. You walking around talking about, I'm a light bearer or a light bringer or a light worker. You fucking silly boys and girls. You don't get light from light. You get light from darkness. You mm-hmm. get what I'm saying? It's a process. And that darkness is represented as the unconscious or the collective unconscious, which is where I commune constantly to bring you all the hot news and information. The collective unconscious, meaning I talk from collectively where we're moving as a people in terms of our evolution. There's a group evolution that's happening to us and a personal evolution. Now, me personally, let me be clear on this, and I say this with a little bit of brag. I know I've evolved. All the people who can see these lights and auras with Kundalini, what happens is you'll get these halos. That's what is represented as the saints have this halo around their head. I've said a number of times, damn, Pam, you got a glow around your head, a halo around your head. I said, yeah, I've reached that level of Kundalini enlightenment. I am not badder or cooler or smarter than you. All I did was decide to fucking put my coloring book down and fucking color. All I see is people who just do not know how to do it, won't do it, too scared to do it, and fronting like they're not scared to do it. So they really scared to get into some shit because they really don't have the confidence, so they waste their time saying Hotep all day and how lovely the queen looks, you know what I'm saying, hoping they'll get a hand job or some kind of shit like that, as opposed to actually really seeing the beauty behind that's really in her, that's really in all of us, that has nothing to do with the physical. Has nothing to do with the physical. These spirits hate your physical presence. They think it's disgusting. When I contacted Oshun and all the rest of them, they showed me the worst thing in existence is to become a human. That's real talk. And they explained that shit so detailed and so vividly and showed me the nauseating feeling. That's the only fear that I would say those spirits really had, or they can kind of speculate on, because remember, they were never human, so they don't know how to help you with your rent or your light bill or your goddamn boyfriend while you think they do. They don't give a fuck about that. They're just energy streams that this prosperity is within your heart. Love is within your heart. They're supposed to help you love yourself. They're supposed to help you be prosperous in yourself so you can able to be empowered to do these things your fucking self. They're not supposed to do that shit for you. But because you think Jesus was supposed to do it for you, now you think Oshun was supposed to find your boyfriend. That's a sick mind, sick, sick mind. You just don't know your shit. You know what I'm saying? You just don't know your shit. You know what I'm saying? Even white people will tell you before you can find somebody to love you, you need to love yourself.
Exactly.
Oshun also represents self-love primarily. And as a form of self-love, you will find a significant other. But if you don't love yourself first, you'll find that's your problem. You know what I'm saying? So much. You're looking for a goddamn soulmate. What's a soul? I don't know what a fucking soul is, but you're looking for a soulmate. So you just want a fuck buddy. Let's be real. You just do fuck buddy spirit work.
Mm-hmm.
Soulmate, my ass. You know what don't even know what that shit is. You got to find who yourself is before you can find a significant balance. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Khadija said it all the time. You'd have met me in the 80s, you would have got no rap, nigga. And I'm like, I fear to tell you, you are fucking right. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't know what the fuck to do. But you know what I'm saying? But I'll tell you this, though. And I probably said it before on the radio. When I was little, when I was like 5 and 6, there's this woman that used to get in the bed with me. And I used to be like, who's this? And like, I used to always dream about this woman. So I told my mom, Mom, there's this lady. She'd be getting in the bed. I was like, oh, that's just a wet dream. I'm like, ain't nothing wet, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, like, I used to dream about this lady. She used to always get in the bed. So I always remembered that face. As soon as I seen Khadija, that was the face. Fucking grown up, I said, that's the motherfucker that used to get in the bed with me. So I already knew what it was. I said, either I'm supposed to be with her forever or this bitch is going to kill me or something. That's what made me move to Atlanta, because I knew it was too real. And but again, so all my life I remember her. But again, if it was the 90s, I would have overlooked her. You get what I'm saying? So is she a soulmate? Yeah. But if I would have met her in the 90s, I wouldn't have seen that, because my soul wasn't prepared. Your soul is there, but you need it's a spark, but you need to cultivate that spark. If you're sitting around and you can't do it on your own and you need help to do that shit, then you're not there. I mean, I get it. Everyone can help you, but your help and doing it for you is two different things. You get what I'm saying? There's something in you that you're going to have to find in yourself that you love. Nobody can convince you of that shit. You know what I'm saying? Something in you you have to find in yourself for you to say, I am ready for whatever. You get what I'm saying? So I had to be ready for her. And soulmate or no, it wouldn't have worked in the 90s just because there's something mystical and magical going. And I used to see her since I was 3, 4, 5 years old. So that's no easy task, but it's work that you have to do on yourself for you to even deserve what you've been calling a soulmate. You get what I'm saying? You ain't going to just get that. You know what I'm saying? You don't even know where the fucking soul is. At the base of the subspinal cord, the subtle body, lies a residual shakti of what they call individualization. So there's different levels of kundalini. Shakti is the primal kundalini force. It represents the life force. Now, at the base of the spine, they call it individualization. When it's sleeping, it's the shakti energy or the kundalini energy becomes a part of the ego. An energy which remains unavailable to the individual as long as his or her consciousness remains firmly rendered in the mundane. As long as you're dealing with the mundane thoughts, your kundalini will not rise. So, if you're talking about Trayvon, Zimmerman, and you think you're conscious, fail. If you're talking about vaccines and what they're doing to you, and what they got planned, and the death camps they're going to put you in, and Jay-Z's fucking Magna Carta, that's some fucking thing that even matters to us? Guess what? Guess the fuck what? You know what I'm saying? No kundalini for you. No kundalini for you. No enlightenment for you. Magna Carta. I see niggas walking around talking about that shit is profound. Kill yourself. You know what I'm saying? Kill yourself. I watched Jay-Z on Bill Maher. This nigga is the most out-of-touch nigga in America. First of all, he's rapping. Did you see that video about with him kissing these white people, putting chains on little white kids? Oh, my God, this shit was so scary. And the niggas talking about he's Picasso, like that's something to live up to and shit. First of all, for you to be looked at as a great artist, you have to challenge minds, motherfucker. You talking about the same bullshit subject
since you was in existence. Your fucking money. This nigga is so out of touch. There was a story going around that this nigga's a time traveler. They don't even believe this nigga's a real nigga. There's a story going around he's a time traveler. Like, and he's talking like he's inspirational to niggas. Nobody is. All you do is just go and abuse niggas with what they ain't got, nigga. And then you drop this Picasso shit. Then he's trying to get deep. He's like, well, early on, you know, rap music, we came out and it was one with the artists and we were in art forums. And I said, you dumb motherfuckers, we were trying to get in the game. You know what I'm saying? It's like nobody, we had to establish ourselves as artists to try to get out of that graffiti vandalism bullshit, you know what I'm saying? That street music shit, that, and it wasn't even music, it was the graffiti and the breakdancing and the graffiti that the art forums took, and Fab Five Freddy was the one who was pushing that bullshit because he was trying to get it in another genre to be taken seriously. And really, it's not because it was hard work and dedication it took seriously. He got that job on fucking MTV Raps as a reward for opening the door to Whitey to make rap a multi-billion-dollar business, not for us, for them. Mm-hmm. It's a multi-billion-dollar business for them. In the goddamn movie, he's taking a white girl to the fucking Bronx and showing her this is what we do. They did that again. Mm. It's an intel. It's one of them fucking FBI. They do that shit time to time. In. They did it with that Clown and Crump shit. Rise. All of a sudden, that's the dance now. They got a whole fucking franchise, which is just as dumb. Step It Up. With a number of white people who break dance now. You ever see this now? They got Step It Up. Yep. Number 75 is out. Exactly. And the entire cast is white people. Why? Because that after that Rise and Clown and Clump bullshit movie, they showed us that's how they get in. With rap music, it was the same thing. It just took a little bit longer, but Fab Five Freddy gave that shit over to them as well. And that's how he got on. And such ignorance in I'm going for the. And then you got conscious niggas talking about how special that shit is. It's bad when Flavor Flav shit on that shit. Flavor Flav shit on that shit.
Wow.
Look, man, that shit ain't even. Him and Chuggy said, look, we was cordial to that nigga until now. You know, enough already. Fucking corporation. You know what I'm saying? And the white boy said, look, we got rich white men who inherit their father's money who's buying states right now. White boy bought North Carolina and did all of this, you know, whatever the white boys do, and hinted to Jay-Z. Stop bragging about chains and buy a state, you dumb motherfucker. And Jay-Z just sat there, that fucking dumb camel laugh. Like, I'm sitting there going, y'all niggas is crazy. And conscious niggas are entertaining this shit. Choke yourself, nigga. Choke yourself. So you have no access to Kundalini. You have no access to lightning. No Kundalini for you. No Kundalini.
No, sir.
No Kundalini.
Yeah, no more.
You.
No more Kundalini.
Let me get some of this commercials out of the way. I'm glad you said commercials. First and foremost, I talked about it before. Very important now to have Orgon in your life. Orgon in your life. Now, if you don't know what it is, I urge you to look it up. It is a substance that is a all around 24 hours, 100% all around. I guess you could say thing that you need in your life. It will help with Kundalini. It will help with pineal activity. It will help with calming the situation. Put it in front of your microwave and help block food. The fucked up shit that comes out your microwave helps with the water. I mean, the laundry list of what Orgonite does is amazing. Now, the good news is we have a brother who makes that stuff to a level of craftsmanship that's just amazing within itself. That's that brother Jerry Miller. So, and I've said it before, and people have been emailing me. If you're not on Facebook, email me, and I'll be happy to give you Jerry Miller's email. You can email me at panicpack@hotmail.com. I'll be happy to pass on his information so you can see what he has going on. When I tell you it is that serious, pyramids and charms and pendants and all sorts of goodies, you need to understand it's a serious business. So that's Jerry Miller. And if you're on Facebook, you can get hit Jerry Miller up. Now, I do want to talk about, there was a sister who called in the last time we talked. If you remember, she said she was going to knit me some shit. And I'm like, knit me some shit? Then she, I said, we might as well knit Adesia some shit. Let me tell you, she sent some hot shit. Now, I'm not one to talk about knitting shit, but she sent some hot shit. Y'all need to see her little lineup. She has a complicated website, so again, this is something to email me. I know she does hats, pocketbooks, scarves, and all the rest of that kind of shit, and plus much more. Sister named Tiffany. She's also in my class, too. And just email me, panicpack@hotmail.com, and I'll pass on her information. But she does shit for babies and the little Rastafarian hats and koofies and all that kind of shit in this office. She got pictures and shit, so need to get with this sister, too. You know what I mean? Real cool sister, real special sister out of Detroit. And, of course, we're about to start up my classes. Let me explain these classes again. If you are not in Atlanta, you can take them via Skype. The classes are very cheap. They are 4 weeks. These are for advanced people who are just starting out. We deal with basics and magic. Like I said, you don't have to take my word for it. You can email some of the people who've taken the class and get from them how it has changed their life, and it has for each person. It's probably one of the best things you can do. So I'm in the third week of a now, so after this cycle is over, we start another cycle, so you want to get in now. You want to email me at panicpack@hotmail.com, and so you can find out more information about the class. I have new packs, plenty of herb packs. If you don't know about the herb packs, you're very late. Helps open up the pineal gland, helps with the kundalini, does all these wonderful things. You got people, like I said, I've been selling this for 3 years now. It is certified. Dignified, bona fide herbal packs, and you can get those at panicpack@hotmail.com. I have new CDs, a new list. So as always, just give me an email, and I'm sure we'll come back next week. We still got more show now, but I'll be back next week. I'm sure Elaine wouldn't mind, and we'll add more and do questions and answers. But we'll keep going
back.
Now. All right, we'll keep going now and all of that. All right. So as we pointed out before the commercials, there's no kundalini for mundane thought. It doesn't sit in the same spot. It doesn't sit. Somebody asked, could they get a panic pack without PayPal? Yes, you can do money orders. Just call me, just email me, and I'll send you the what to do next. So, yeah, I've been doing money orders and, but like I said, I urge you to take the class. That's where big ideas happen. You get what I'm saying? Big shit happens for people. Like I said, I've had people who are experts take the class and still walk out and say, well, goddamn. I said, this is a very intense, hard training for 4 weeks. And I recorded them, so if you miss a class, you can get a recording of it. All right, so mundane thought does not, you can't have it both ways. I need you to understand that, folks. You can't have it both ways. The more you think in the mundane, the more you suppress kundalini energy. Kundalini sleeps in humanity. So the more you deal with human thought, human issues, and even try to make human issues spiritual, you need to cut that bullshit out. You know what I'm saying? Cut that bullshit out. Stop trying to make fucking Jay-Z fucking Abraxas or some kind of shit like that. He's a fucking idiot from Marcy that figured out that that's used as a fucking puppet to sell kids, sell you imaginary dreams. They make him rich because they know he will not say anything or do anything to challenge status quo. In fact, he will do things to keep you ignorant and keep you chasing something that doesn't exist. That's his job. That's his role. And while he did that, he was able damn near single-handedly to decline the entire face of rap into a non-creative force. At the very least, black folks here had their little creative things, had their little creation going. You can't even say that in music anymore. You have nothing now. You get what I'm saying? You have nothing. You have nothing but this shit. You know what I'm saying? Consciousness. Okay, and also, before I forget, you want to go to DrLeanBay.com. You know what I'm saying? Dr. Lean Bay, he has the chakra stone. This is about Kundalini, and he has a lot of shit now. Don't get me wrong. Now, Dr. Lin Bay has been doing this for quite some time. So, but one of the things I know is a must is because people say it to me all the time, where can I get stones? Where can I get stones? Where can I get stones? Well, you can get them from Dr. Lin Bay. You get seven stones. Thanks, sorry. You get seven stones and that'll be your chakra stones, and they'll correspond to your like I said, we're going to get into that deeper as we get into the Q&A next week, things you could do. So that's one of the things you could do. Now, I haven't told Dr. Aline yet, but I found a place out here that's a good price for lectures. So we're going to do part two. If y'all wasn't at the first one with Dr. Aline, was a fucking smash. We did a sexual energy one, and Dr. Lee brought it. So I haven't got a chance to talk to him yet because the places out here were hard. But I was with my girl Star, the rapper. And by the way, that's the only shit I listen to. My girl Star and Kill Ripken. That's the only rappers I've been listening to lately. And Star had a show, and there's a spot down here has a good price, and they not only that, they have their own sound and they film. There's nothing more you can ask for. So I'm thinking about we're gonna try it again. I didn't get a chance to go over the details of Brother Lean, but right now would be an excellent time for this, that, and the other thing, and so I'll discuss it with him, and we'll try maybe for October. But this is what I need. I need to know that you niggas are going to show the fuck up. Now, I'm going to get with Aline, make sure the damn stars are right when we do it. All that Mercury and retrograde shit ain't going to happen. So I'm going to get with them to see the most perfect time around the October time. But I need some commitments from y'all. Let me know. Y'all either going to come out. I need Atlanta to show up. So, you know, we'll do it right, but I need y'all to give me the feedback to make me know this is something we should do, because it is very, not only is it costly, it's very time-consuming to do it, and if nobody shows up, it really takes a lot. You know what I mean? It's hard for me to even come on the radio based upon classes and mailing out herb packs and studying. So to add this to my plate as well, it's got to be worth it. So, and it's only for y'all, because Aline will come and drop it. You get what I'm saying? So, and you know, so like I said, we still working with it, but y'all guys, let me know if you're down for this. Right? And we did the Holy Orgasm lecture last time. Lionel Martin. It's a classic lecture, and like I said, you know, me being new to it, we didn't get the film like we wanted and so on and so forth. But there ain't going to be none of that now. So let's get it on, folks. All right, so energy is our personal fragment. This energy, Kundalini energy, is our personal fragment of cosmic power or self-identification. Thanks solely to the sense of I-ness, The Kundalini energy brings you in the sense of I-ness, one with self, as opposed to the sense of me-ness, which is the ego, which is the ego. And that mundane thought keeps you in, by its very nature, keeps feeding the ego. And the Kundalini that sleeps at the base of the spine actually will go to serve the ego. It will sit at the base of the spine and just feed the ego, basically. So when it's raised up, it feeds celestial consciousness. Kundalini self-identifies with every cell in your body from conception until death. You instantly die as soon as she ceases to self-identify with you. So Kundalini is what's running you. Kundalini is what is your life force. You get what I'm saying? Is your life force. The ability to visualize, cultivate, and do things to raise it is your true quality of life. But you hear people talking about this is done through diet. Now, not to shun your diet. You get what I'm saying? Whatever you eat is up to you. Whatever works for you, works for you. But it's not the key to enlightenment. Kundalini is the motherfucking key to enlightenment. You get what I'm saying? It is your life force energy. I don't care how many carrots you eat. Without Kundalini, you're dead. No matter how much carrots you juice. The more you identify with your individuality, the microcosm, the more she functions as your own personal illusion. The more she reflects the macrocosm as you identify with your individuality. She is free to reflect more of the microcosm, once you free her to increase her awareness of the one. Kundalini are names for the same manifest in two different directions. So there's two different directions of Kundalini they talk about here. Maya Shakti and Chit Shakti. Maya Shakti is the illusional form of Kundalini, and that's the person identifying with their own identity. Really, it's really just juicing the ego. So when you ever hear people talking about, oh, my Kundalini is tingling, and oh, you made my Kundalini do this, and my Kundalini do that, you might as well just say, oh, you made my pussy tingle, you made my dick tingle. You know what I'm saying? Because it's really you're talking about Maya Shakti. You're not which is a sensation you feel, and is not saying the sensation is fake, but it's a mundane version of Kundalini activation. It's a mundane level of it, and then there are a more advanced level of it called Chit Shakti. You get what I'm saying? The celestial thing where you are connected to what they call, as I pointed out earlier, the collective unconscious. Whereas I've tapped into Kundalini levels where I feel connected to everybody, everything, and every entity. You get what I'm saying? Same show, Bill Maher. There was a brain surgeon who died. And the brain surgeon wrote a book, I Was a Butterfly, when he died. Because he said he could actually feel he became a butterfly and he was flying and, you know, all of this shit. And they're shitting all over him, of course. But, you know, he's got this credible, you know, they're saying, you know, he's doing this book because he's this credible brain surgeon or whatever. And they just can't believe he's saying he was a butterfly. See, well, what happened was he went to this quantum connection where all life force is connected. Chit Shakti, or a level of Kundalini life force where you are connected to everything. So when you say I'm God, what's God? The all. That means you are able to experience everything. Overwhelmed. As a human, you identify with individualism. You identify with how can I fly, walk, talk, and shit at the same time. You need to be able to do things in compartment. And even then, as black folks, we still was able to deal with a little bit more holistic concepts, and we've still been subjugated and compartmentalized based upon white thought, even within the realm of individualization as a human. So the quantum connection is that all connectedness. And he was explaining the quantum Shakti Kundalini experience, Kundalini life experience that's greater than the Kundalini individual Mayan Shakti experience, you know, how Jay-Z makes you feel and how this and that one makes you feel and shit. Now, that's good because, remember, as I pointed out, I said you don't want to go crazy with that because you are supposed to know the differences. You get what I'm saying? So there's no crime for you to like Jay-Z. You know what I mean? Don't get me wrong. There's no crime for you to be able to listen to Magna Carta and to be able to say, well, I like it or I don't like it. When you try to make that shit spiritual, though, that's when you went crazy. You get what I'm saying? That's when you went fuck crazy. When you trying to make Nicki Minaj spiritual, you lost your fucking mind. If you cannot sit there just because you personally like her, you know what I'm saying? Which I can't figure that out anyway, but that's just me. But see, there's shit that I personally like that I'm not going to force down your throat as spiritual. You get what I'm saying? I love Ghostface Killer, but I'm not going to tell you he's motherfucking Obatala. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Because I feel a certain way about him. You get what I'm saying? I know the difference. To me, I think he's amazing as a rapper and as a talent and so on and so forth, but so the fuck what? You get what I'm saying? That doesn't amount to no more than my opinion. So I'm not going to put my opinion on you and call it fucking spiritual and deep. You get what I'm saying? You know what I mean? So because this is the understanding that about self-identification versus collective unconsciousness. You get what I'm saying? Collective unconsciousness. So, and then we don't want to get it confused with manners as well. And I'm saying, oh, Panic, you're so coarse. So what? That has nothing to do with finding light. It has nothing to do with going to heaven. It has nothing to do with me loving you or giving you something because I'm courteous or not. What you need to know is, have I given you enough for you to take and do your own work? That's all that really matters. So let's see what else we got here. All right, let's keep going and see where we're at. Maya Shakti keeps you awake to the world. Remember, Maya means the illusion. So the illusional Shakti keeps you awake to the world and asleep to the absolute. When Chick Shakti awakens you to reality and puts you in a sleep and puts you to sleep with regards to worldly matters. It puts you asleep to regards to worldly matters. Now, this is one thing niggas do got right. Because it's the easiest thing, even though it's actually kooky if you think about it. You'll hear niggas say, I don't watch TV no more. I don't watch the news anymore. Because they have elevated themselves, because the news' sole design is to keep you involved in worldly matters. So, Maya Shakti, or the illusional Shakti, keeps you awake to the world and asleep to the absolute. Chick Shakti awakes you to reality and puts you asleep with regard to the worldly matters. To worldly matters. Which means, so niggas say, well, I don't watch TV no more. It's the idiot box. I don't watch TV. Meanwhile, they're on the fucking internet. You know what I'm saying? This is just as idiotic. What, they're on the internet saying it. They're on the internet saying, I don't watch TV. I'm better than that. You get what I'm saying? niggas kill me with this shit. This goddamn conscious performance. It has got to stop. No Kundalini for you. No Kundalini for you. Now, but at the very least, they have turned off CNN and the rest of that shit until it came to fucking Trayvon. You know what I'm saying? Right. Now, This is because they're still dealing in the realm of illusion. They haven't really been able to let this drug go. Now, me, you'll hear, it'll come out coarse because we're in a situation where I have to explain this in a quick, fast hurry. Because I've talked about humanity in class, and I've talked about that for 3 hours. So there's stuff we have to cover in 3 hours. If I really was to break down this, the real science of humanity and its problems, we'd be here all day. So I have to say things that are a little bit more shocking, you get what I'm saying, to make the point. But ultimately, what you're hearing is the result of me dealing with chick shakti, closing myself down to worldly matters. It's not just because I hate humanity and humanity's full of suckers. You know what I'm saying? No, we're talking about I made a choice to relieve myself or take myself as far away I could from Maya Shakti and step into the absolute, which is Chick Shakti, which awakened myself to the reality and puts me asleep to the worldly matters, which means what suffers is my courtesy and my plight for you to save your kids. Somebody sent me a goddamn email about donating to some kids. Fuck that. I shut that down. It's not that I don't have compassion for some kids that are starving, but that's not my work. But mm-hmm. See, I do tell you this. There are plenty of people on the planet Earth who are here to do that. That's exactly. Who you need to solicit. That's who you need to solicit. See, when Trayvon died, this cause is for people. It's for people who are into this cause. They don't need conscious people to do that. They got human people to do that. That's what this is. You get what I'm saying? That's what this is. You are supposed to have said, I have gone beyond these worldly issues. I have gone beyond the excitement of Jay-Z's fucking album dropping. Not to say you can't comment or not talking about it or ignoring it doesn't make you conscious. But you know what I'm talking about when your emotions are in that bullshit. You know what I'm saying? Now, I've talked about it, gigged about it, laughed about it, but really, after Facebook, there's nothing said about it. I don't give a fuck about that guy. You know what I'm saying? He's a corporation that is doing what he's supposed to be. He's doing what we as conscious people, there's no kundalini for you. There's no kundalini for you. Since the consciousness of a living being is conditioned by the matter in which it resides, the greatest Maya or illusion that we experience is Maya of matter, which makes up our bodies. So they're saying basically you were born, just by having the body, you were born into this illusion, and your task is laid before you in terms of your fight throughout Maya or out of the illusion based upon just having a human body, period. Just based upon being born in matter, period, it automatically, so you're not going to, so when I hear these people talking about, well, I always was like that. No, the fuck you wasn't. You wouldn't have been born here. You get what I'm saying? You always had something in your spirit telling you that the shit is wrong, but you're not like that. Otherwise, we wouldn't be having this conversation. You being born in matter says what chore is before you, says what goal is before you, and that's really coming out of these illusions. And what we're doing is treading lightly on how we think is easy because we're talking better than the average Joe. We talk better than, we talk better than your Christian friend or how you used to talk when your mother made you go to church. So we think that alone is accomplishment, along with the power words like hotep. But that's only the beginning of consciousness, as I said. It's not enlightenment. Now, let's see where we're at. So as long as we live, have embedded, embodied
So as long as we live in this embodied life, each one of us participates in the play of nature, binding ourselves to the world and to things. We accrue in our personalities. No incarnate being can either be holy, worldly, or worldly spiritual, no matter how fulfilled with light you may become. You never quite transcend your dark side fully, and as long as you remain embodied. So what this tells us is there's no perfection. That's what we tend to look for when we talk to somebody. Oh, Lean is perfectly perfected. You know, that doesn't exist down here. Not as long as you have a body. As long as you have a body, you will do human shit. I don't give a fuck how advanced you are. This is one of the things Bobby Hemmett was talking about now. He's like, look, you have to, he's one of the things you have to forgive these niggas for being these niggas. And I'm like, fuck these niggas, you know, early on especially. He's like, no, you have to forgive these niggas because they just these niggas. You know what I'm saying? What is in them is magical. What they are is has nothing to do, you know. If anyone deserves to be crazy, it's us. You get what I'm saying? We've been here long enough to be crazy. We have the birthright to be crazy. But what you're cultivating and what you're dealing with has nothing to do with what's on the outside or what's in what behavior that you witness. You know what I'm saying? And of course, it's sickening, and I don't mind telling the nigga to kiss my ass. But at the end of the day, why am I talking to you then? If it was just this hate thing, because what I'm talking to is bigger than your personality. It's bigger than my personality, which are both nothing but illusions. So that is the connection that you have to go on. That is the inspiration that you have to go on, understanding that as long as you have a body, there will be a flaw. Once you come to terms with that, then you can get down to business. Because what people are looking for is something that's flawless. It doesn't exist. It doesn't exist. It will not exist in the human body. That is just the nature of the human body. Kundalini, or matter, I should say, Kundalini will eventually awaken in every being in the universe. If you prefer to enjoy karma, you can wait for that awakening to happen, to dawn on you. Otherwise, you can arrive. You can actively try to find your way out of that state. Based upon choices. Now, T. Freeman L. talked about that. He said everyone evolves. No matter trying or not, everyone eventually will evolve. Some who are conscious, dealing with the alchemy, are actually just active in their evolution. Everyone else is basically dealing with what they've been calling karma. And basically, which does not exist. Your agreement with what you think to be bad based upon morals that were actually, you were trained by, morals that were given to you, social training that was, somebody told you to sit up straight and say thank you, and that was bad form, and a lady does this and a man does that. Someone trained you into this form of thinking. Therefore, you built what you think is manners in etiquette based upon something that's created for you, usually by your parents, something that's created for you in terms of mind control. So what you see as good and bad has been created for you as well through society or through your parents. And with this being said, your ideas of karma, your ideas of good and bad luck have all been, it's all in your own mind. So as the true alchemist, the true person, what they're trying to point out here is to take form of your evolution, you need to get rid of the concept of good and bad in terms of guilt and shame that you put on yourself. We're not talking about kicking old ladies down the stairs or throwing babies off the roof or drowning kittens. But, you know, because if you're not dealing with the worldly events, you're not dealing with that stuff anyway. But let's say you've done these things. You get what I'm saying? Or things that you're not proud of, to be more realistic. And most of us spend our lives beating ourselves up over this shit and morals, you know, these fake morals and this fake dignity that you're striving for, usually trying to prove to the person that told you what the fuck dignity was in the fucking first place. Once you come to the level of who gives a fuck what they think, who gives a fuck, this is about your transformation and nothing is more important than that, you're able to start releasing them or releasing their power over you. You get what I'm saying? This goes for your children, your parents. They have a power over you you don't even realize they have based upon you trying to be moral, you trying to do the right thing. You're trying to be honest and earnest and all the rest of these things, but not even sticking to the bullshit that we say each day on Facebook that everyone has their own path. What happened to, even if it's your son and he's supposed to be a bum, or your daughter and she's supposed to be a stripper, this is what they're supposed to do. You get what I'm saying? What happened to that? You know, everybody gets deep when it's some shit that works for them, you know what I'm saying? But when it's some shit that doesn't work, can you stay in that range? You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Can you still stick with that laws of attraction theory and all the rest of that? And I find it's very hard to do that. You know what I'm saying? Panic, you know, it's divine and all in divine order, and things are happening like they're supposed to be. Then a week later, Patty, my daughter says she want to be a stripper. What ritual can I do? Like, what happened to all that divine order? You know what I'm saying? And all the rest of that shit. So understanding that it's their path, and you can't keep them off the pole if that's where they're trying to go. And because evolution, what's happening here is for this to be successful here on planet Earth, we have to go through everything. In other words, we have to leave no stone unturned, so there's nothing to ever come back to a reality like this for. There's no question left. You get what I'm saying? There's no equation unanswered. There's nothing unaddressed. So everybody's got to do something. You don't get to say this is an illusion one day when it's working for you, and then when some shit happens, you know what I'm saying, you know, your shit hit the fan. You get what I'm saying? Now, I get it. Somebody stabbing you with a knife, you ain't going to be sitting there, oh, shit, well, don't worry, it's an illusion. You know what I'm saying? You're going to haul your ass. But we talking about shit that's a little less dramatic. You get what I'm saying? A little less intense. You might have to sit back and really start saying to yourself, well, why don't I apply some of this shit that I like saying on Facebook in my status messages? How about that? When we imagine, when we malign Maya, for Ma always gives us that which we ask for. When we call on the goddess to ask her for mundane boons, which bind us to two limited forms. So that's what I talk about all the time, dealing with these gods and goddesses for mundane boons. Rents, girlfriend, boyfriends, fucking soulmates, all the rest of these mundane things. It limits you or binds you to us, our limited form. So you're doing more than getting over until another time. You are literally making yourself fucking human. You are literally binding yourself to the human body, literally, by just asking
But you, and you're really asking the guts. You're just asking the energy for something mundane. She appears to us as Maya or the illusion. When we pray to her power and energy, she manifests the Shakti. She manifests the Shakti. When we give it power and energy, see what I'm saying? So again, what they're talking about, if you ask for bullshit, it shows up as bullshit and it limits you. But when you use these gods, as I point out in my class, for higher purposes, it shows up as life force. You get what I'm saying? So is that same God could be your enemy or your friend. You get what I'm saying? So this is where we get this concept, Oshun was mad at me. Well, Oshun is mad at your fucking ass because you're asking her for human shit. You get what I'm saying? And this is a deity that was never human. So that's where you get this kind of, she was mad or she gave me help. So when you ask these gods for higher shit, you know what I'm saying, oddly enough, all the mundane shit seems to work the fuck out. Whoa, boy. And it's a simple concept. Alchemists never permit themselves to passively defined by external environment. They define themselves, and by doing so, define their surroundings. So, again, so defining yourself as opposed to being defined. Now, what I can really say by looking at the social network, which is where we all are, I see people being defined by the social network. If it's hot to say this, that's the hot shit people say. If it's not hot to say this, then you don't say that. You know what I'm saying? If somebody says something un-ho-teppy, then they get ridiculed for that. You get what I'm saying? If they say something that's ho-teppish, they finally get all these loves and all these likes and these fucking hearts. The fuck is that? You know what I'm saying? Oh, that's just so worthy of a heart. You know what I'm saying? It's so worthy of a heart icon. I like that. You know what I'm saying? Now, it's nothing wrong with that, but you get the kind of feeling it's like it's an agenda being pushed or definitions being pushed. Or it's people are doing things now because what they're doing is being passively defined by an external environment. And it says, the alchemist never permits themselves to be passively defined. So I never put up nothing so people go, oh, panic, heart, laugh out loud panic. You know what I'm saying? None of that. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. I put shit up, niggas go, why the fuck you do that, panic? I don't care. I thought this shit was funny. You know what I'm saying? I like granny porn. So they define themselves. Right, they define themselves. And by doing this, define their surroundings. You get what I'm saying? Now, if anybody was the master at that, it was damn sure Bobby Hemmick. You know what I'm saying? This nigga was a genius at defining himself. Like, even now, after he was at the hospital, he had to go through the therapy. And all this nigga had to find out was he went to the same place where Superman was. This nigga was on it. You know what I'm saying? This nigga did the theme music. No panic, I was at where Superman was. He loved every minute of it. He just knew how to define his own shit. Christopher Reeves was there. So this nigga said, Superman was there, nigga. That was his whole shit, because he was on the Superman kick. So he was like, Superman was there. You know what I'm saying? So this nigga was real. You should hear this nigga. This nigga sound the same. This shit is amazing. Pam, what channels did you get? I'm like, God damn, nigga, already? And I'm like, damn, nigga, how's the applesauce or some shit? He's like, shit, nigga. I was talking to this nigga. I was flying. I was doing this. Some mad nigga said you was up in the dreams. Like, I figured, what's the channels, nigga? I'm like, God damn, nigga, you about business. So, you know, this is, he was always one of the niggas that showed me how you define your own surroundings. Like, who the fuck is keeping, like, I just really just got it one day. I'm like, who the fuck is telling you otherwise? You know what I'm saying? And there's a statement that backs that up in those chaos books, Phil Hines, Peter Carroll, one of them Libra No Psychonaut books, standard reading. You know, there's that statement, fake it until you make it. And you're like, okay, I get it, you know, on an intellectual level. But that shit penetrated. And I even get it on where they're talking about metaphysically. You know, like, you know, you basically say, if you basically saying, I got a Ferrari long enough, eventually you'll be walking around this motherfucker with a Ferrari jacket. You know what I'm saying? Ferrari gloves, Ferrari posters. Eventually you're going to be like, oh, how the fuck did I get this Ferrari? You get what I'm saying? I remember there was a drum machine in the 80s. All you old hip hoppers, you know, the Emu SP-1200. And this shit was, at back then, was like $4,000. There was just no fucking way this shit was going to happen. All I did was clear out a space on my dresser for that shit. You know what I'm saying? And then there's this drug dealer in the hood said, I want to be a rapper. So I know how you could be a rapper. You gotta buy us a drum machine. And that nigga bought that shit the next day. You know what I'm saying? But I had everything ready prepared for the drum machine. I ain't know nothing about none of that shit. Later on, it's the laws of attraction and visualization and all the rest of that kind of shit that did that shit. But it started making me understand the statements of, like, fake it until you make it. You get what I'm saying? And then seeing Bobby Hemmick, this nigga make anything up on the spot. I said, this shit is genius. You get what I'm saying? Who the fuck is keeping score? In terms of, that ain't true. That's some shit you learn. Make it true. What the fuck? What's real? You get what I'm saying? What's real? So all of that to say, you have to start defining yourself. You don't let social group, person, myself, anybody tell you what you're doing is great. Don't look for my fucking approval. Your greatest victory is you approving your own shit. You get what I'm saying? First World Order on the radio. Every Wednesday, we'll be back next Wednesday as well. So when Kundalini awakens before death, she will try to return and unite with her opposite pole, the pole of greatest awareness, which is the Shiva. The Shiva is the pineal gland, or code for your pineal gland. By reversing the outward protection of the energy, which led to the incarnation. So the incarnation was the Shakti energy falling into the base chakra. During death, you get a Kundalini rush of his leaving. That's when you get the DMT rush. Because the Kundalini or the Shakti energy is leaving. And then there's the bait that leads through the neck, through the mouth, through the top of the head, depending on your consciousness and so on and so forth. Now, Shiva is, in the mythology, is your pineal gland. Shiva is the dead god, basically, or the sleeping god, or he's just a lazy fucker. And his Shakti energy, once she meets him, he wakes up. That's his primal, that's his first primal goddess. So they'll say in Hindu mythology, whatever god's consort is their Shakti. You get what I'm saying? Their life force. So every woman represents your Shakti energy. Your woman is your Shakti energy because she gives you life force. In Oracle of the Illuminati, which is the book on Tarot, they talk about Mary Magdalene as the Shakti energy for Jesus Christ. Now, these weren't real people. It's just an old concept just being rehashed. Yeah. And even in the Bible, they talked about this cloak of the Illuminati, or Jason in the Technicolor dream cloak is actually the chakras or the feminine energy. And how even you'll hear Vishnu was sleeping, then these goddesses wash his feet and he wakes up. They talk about Shakti energy from Malkuth or the base, because the feet on the legs are just an extension of the root chakra, and as the arms are an extension of the throat chakra, creativity. And they talk about in the Bible how Mary washed Jesus' feet with her hair. It represents her putting her consciousness and rising him up. Jesus and Vishnu are the same Christ figure. So Shakti, like people will say, the wedding is all wrong, that the man should meet the woman and all the rest of that. But really, if you look at the Shiva Shakti story, the wedding is still right. Shiva's sleeping at the altar, and, you know, she has on white, which represents the spine, and she's walking up the aisle to meet and wake up the groom, which is Shiva. So she's the Shakti energy meeting the Shiva energy. Even though people say, well, it's reversed, you know, I heard cultists say that it's reversed. It should be, he should be walking to her and all of this stuff, to the great mother and all that. I guess it depends on how you look at it, but in the Shiva Shakti story, Shiva represents your sleeping pineal gland. You know, he's nothing but a hemp smoker, you know what I mean, a raggedy fuck until he meets his Shakti energy. And all his different consorts are different levels of Shakti, Parvati, Sati, which later became the Lingam, and Kali, which is his form of Shiva the Destroyer, and Shiva the Lightbringer, and Shiva the Destroyer. Parvati, which is his form of the husband, you know what I'm saying? So that's the one to watch out for. That's the one Khadija came as, Parvati, to make me a regular guy now, a regular Joe. I'm a regular stiff. Because Khadija, I'm a regular stiff. And but then they'll say, she will say, like, he used to laugh at Parvati because he used to say there's something black inside of you. He was talking about Kali. He was talking about the dark side of the woman, which I can laugh at Khadija because there's something black inside her ass, boy. Y'all think she's nice. That nigga right there, boy. You don't want to cross her. I'm scared of her ass. Like, I hope she don't hear this now, as a matter of fact. If you're awakening Kundalini, it unites totally with her Shiva, and you will cease to exist, since nothing will remain to identify with your body. She is awakened slowly enough so you can digest the tremendous energies which are released. She lets go of everything that's been holding you down. You become a man or woman of God. So basically, they're telling you about this connection. You, if you truly make this connection, your human problem starts to dwindle away. We're not talking about not caring where you let the rent go, because that's not dealing with it. You go beyond that. You go beyond to where solutions for paying your rent, your gas bill, your love starts to you will be able to find those answers. You'll be able to find those answers because what happens is you have superseded remember when we talked about if you're asking for petty things, it actually expands the pettiness of your life.
Yes.
So actually asking for rent and girlfriends actually expands that problem. Now, if you're dealing with these energies for higher reasons, what happens is humanity is actually a lower cause. Therefore, the lower cause actually starts to iron itself out, ironically, starts to iron itself out. So dealing with the higher shit, the lower shit starts to balance itself out based upon you are actually superseding the bullshit. You get what I'm saying? You are going beyond the bullshit, and the bullshit becomes a slave or a bitch to something greater that you're dealing with, oddly enough. My ego self-identifies with the body, and if it were to leave my body, I would immediately become limp and dead. So it's telling you that you need your ego. The ego is self-identifies with the body. This is more of you needing to understand that the ego does have a role. It's not necessarily to be celebrated or enhanced. You don't have to enhance it. The ego is just going to exist based upon you just being in matter. You get what I'm saying? The idea is you're supposed to know exactly what the fuck it is so you know where it needs to be applied. If someone is pushing you around, you don't get to go, well, I'm conscious and I'm better. You know, you better stick foot to ass. You get what I'm saying? The awakening of Kundalini release all stresses. The awakening of Kundalini release all stresses. And let me say that again. The awakening of Kundalini release all stresses. So instead of trying to run around with your, like a, following your own tail, if you will, you know, following your own tail about, you know, your rent, your job, your boss, your girlfriend, this nigga trying to do that to you on Facebook. If you deal with the Kundalini, those stresses seem to disappear. You need to supersede your humanity. See, we're too busy trying to defeat humanity. You will never do it. Your ego will not let you do it. Your ego will always give you something else to deal with in humanity because that's how it survives. Your ego survives based upon human trials and tribulations. So the more you deal in human trials, the more you try to satisfy human trials and tribulations, the more your ego will give you more because that's what it needs for it to survive.
Mm-hmm.
It cannot survive without something happening. So as soon as you get finished with Trayvon, I bet you niggas forgot about Sean Bell. Remember him?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Sean Bell, Sean Bell, Sean Bell. I don't even hear that nigga name no more. Trayvon. Trayvon. Skittles. You niggas are so unimaginative in terms of the mind control that they got, that they putting down, seriously.
Not
going to
hear no more about Trayvon either.
Yeah, I mean, you know, right, you're not going to hear no more. Right, he's already fading the fuck out, you know what I'm saying? Already fading the fuck
exactly,
out.
Exactly.
He probably more happy about that shit than, you know, than I am.
Right.
And like I said, you know, Sean Bell and what they did to that boy, you know what I'm saying? Unmeasurable shit, you know what I'm saying? It's like they're doing this to distract you. And then you know when Trayvon starts fading out, when they start giving you the other cases. But the same thing happened to a lady the other day. Yep, it's happening all the time. They did that shit with O.J.
Mm-hmm.
Well, two white women, a white man and a white woman killed, just like O.J., but we all talk about O.J. It's like, oh, come on, man. It's like, that's the ultimate in mind control. That's the ultimate in mind control. I've never seen mind control. And anybody conscious dealing with that, is you're not conscious. You're mundane. No Kundalini for you. No Kundalini for you.
Mm-hmm.
When she does awaken in a controlled way, she awakens slowly and reveals herself gradually. So Kundalini is a gradual process. Ain't no, I read this book today and it happens tomorrow. It is, that's why you need to get into some form of a practice, some form of a routine. And when you're no longer making progress with that, you need to find something else to keep going. Knowledge is endless. This shit is boundless, which is another way of saying it never stops. You never reach the end. You get what I'm saying? You never reach the end. Not when you have no body. If you have a body, that means you're not through. You have graduated when you die. And dying means anything. You can get hit in the head with a fucking safe. Walking down fucking Susquehanna Street, you know what I'm saying, to the Susquehanna Hat Company, and a safe to fall on your fucking head, and if that's the way you go, a George Zimmerman can pop a cap in your ass, and if that's the way you go, that's the way you were meant to go, by your definition, you get what I'm saying, by your definition, and niggas ain't even getting it. even with the Trayvon thing,
no,
the shit that George Zimmerman did will never, ever happen again. There's no white man that's going to shoot no kid and ever get away with it again. Niggas ain't going to have that fight. Not because we are powerful. It's just too embarrassing for white folks. It's not because they're scared of us. They're scared of us arguing and shit. But it's just too – white people can't – won't sit with that. Okay, now it's two of them, so it's not a special thing. So number two ain't never going to happen. You get what I'm saying? It'll just be another way niggas is getting killed. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So not saying niggas ain't going to get killed. Just saying it ain't going to happen in that scenario no more just because he got away.
Right, exactly.
So even the humans have a victory there. You get what I'm saying? They can't do – they can't pull that hat trick off. You know what I'm saying? And nobody's seeing that. Like, it's like they're telling you what to occupy your mind with. That's mind control 101. They're telling you what to occupy your mind with. That's mind control 101. You ain't getting past that. You got to do better than that. As long as the Kundalini Shakti self-identifies with the body, she remains asleep. Once she awakens, she searches for her mate, Shiva, or the pioneer gland. So basically, your goal is to raise that Kundalini to the third eye. If you identify him with the body, it remains asleep. So if you're talking about Magna Carta, you sleeping. If you're talking about Trayvon, you sleeping. Not saying you're not an honorable person. Not saying you haven't looked at enough YouTube. Not saying you don't have a nice library. But your Kundalini is sleeping because you put it to sleep by putting your mind in that area, by putting your mind on those things. Anybody promoting that bullshit to you got you fucked up.
Yes, sir.
Got you fucked up.
Mm-hmm.
This is Oprah Winfrey subjects. This is Oprah Winfrey shit. You're not conscious doing what Oprah Winfrey does. You're not conscious doing what Oprah Winfrey does.
Not exactly.
You're not conscious doing what Dr. Phil does. That's why they do it, because they're talking to masses. If the same subject you're talking about is on fucking Alanya Van Zandt, you fucked up. Beloved, you fucked up. Just because you use Hoteps and Beloveds and the Buriganis and all of that, just adding that to a human subject. That ain't gonna do it. You know what I'm saying? Anybody who's so called teaching you conscious work and you there for conscious work, you make sure you're not dealing with Monday shit that you can find out on your own on goddamn ABC. You get what I'm saying? Fucking Jesse the Body Ventura is talking conspiracy theories. Why are we talking about fucking Magna Carta? That shit's on Bill Maher. You know what I'm saying? Who gives a, you know what I'm saying? Why are we talking about that in terms of our conscious movement? That's the best we got? Now, I get it. I mean, you know, I'm lighthearted. I like to joke and all of that. I'd rather joke than try to pretend to be deep. You get what I'm saying? Try to pretend to be deep. Facebook is for jokes. Facebook is for tagging people. Motherfuckers on that shit, man, like they in the fucking Anchor Watts or some shit. You know what I'm saying? like they on Sirius or some kind of shit. And you know, it's not that, you know, it, get into granny porn. If you want to liberate the ego from her restrictions, you must create a force within your body to counteract the force of gravity. This can only be done by strength and perseverance. The purpose of all spiritual practices and religions, in every religion, is to disengage the ego from her identification, but with the limited personality so they may reunite with her true personality. So you have to do that. They're letting you know you have to purposefully take steps to acknowledge and liberate yourself or be conscious of your ego. It just doesn't happen because you read a book. It just doesn't happen because you listen to Bobby Hemming. You get what I'm saying? It's something that just doesn't happen. You're going to have to take steps and do things to make that reality so.
Mm-hmm.
While Kundalini sleeps in the base chakra at the base of the spine, you are awake to the world and sleep to reality. When she awakes to unite with her Shiva in your brain, when you wake up to reality, you fall asleep to this world. An ignorant person believes that he is in the world. This Kundalini itself identifies with the poison of Maya. So an ignorant person believes that he's in this motherfucking world doing his goddamn thing. Doing his goddamn thing. This could be determined by his self-identity. So when you hear people talking about how great they like Nicki Minaj and Jay-Z and all that, that's fine, but that's personal and self-identification. When they
right.
add spirituality to that, when they add spirituality to that, that's when they lost their fucking mind. You get what I'm saying? That's when they lost their fucking mind. That's when Kundalini goes wild. When Kundalini goes wild, Spring Break edition. We say that Kundalini is sleeping because she, the ego, is self-identifying with the individual's limited personality.
Mm.
Because all of this self-identification, she accepts the limits and she accepts limits as her limits. She lies under three coverings, which prevents her from remembering who she is and where she belongs. Talking about,
talking about
the third dimension. Who she is and where she is. So they're saying the consciousness in your Kundalini cannot bust through your ego, and your thoughts, your very own thoughts, are what keeps it down. You could judge this meter. Are you thinking like everybody else thinks? That's it. Are you thinking like everybody else thinks? What you think about as deep, did Oprah cover it? So, again, when you were saying The Secret was deep, when it was on Oprah, it's no longer deep. That's when you move on to the laws of Tahuti. You get what I'm saying? Say, oh, I get it. The laws of attraction, that's just one of six other laws. You get what I'm saying? You shouldn't still be walking around laws of attraction. Why? Because Oprah has made it mundane. It's in the field of mundane thought now.
Mm-hmm. Yes, exactly.
It's in the field of mundane thought now. And you are doing everything, or should be doing everything in your power to go beyond mundane fucking thought.
Yeah.
See, if Trayvon, you're underestimating it's underestimating the fact that somebody even gives a fuck what they're doing with the conspiracy of Trayvon. No one gives a fuck. It does not make you more of a god or less of a god. It just makes you more of a human to deal with that subject.
Hmm.
And that's a fact.
Mm-hmm.
That's a fact. What does that have to do with your ancient study? Please, somebody explain that shit to me. We know they're going to do what they've been trying to do. What the fuck is new? They've been killing Trayvon since we got here.
Exactly. Yes, sir.
Since they got on the planet. You get what I'm saying?
Day one for them.
Day one for them. So what is this new news for you? Oh, and they're doing this and they're going to do that. They always been going to do some shit. We've been talking about the shit they going to do for the longest. Ain't been talking about the shit we going to do for, you know what I mean? We just fucking ho-tepping each other to death. Stop saying ho-tep and do some fucking magic. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Right.
Really?
Conditioned knowledge is always slightly distorted, and unconditional knowledge is truly straight. Meaning, if you're dealing with a system, you got to remember, no matter what system and no matter how advanced the system, now the system is going to be, whatever system it may be, is going to be advanced for you because maybe you're coming out of another system that was less advanced. And most folks came out of some form of religious system. So any system they go, you know, since they're used to a system, they go to another system, and it seems like it's advanced, but we need to understand that a conditioned system or conditioned knowledge is what they call it is there. Conditioned knowledge is always slightly
Conditioned knowledge is always slightly distorted. So which means no matter how good the intentions are of any group, it's got to be slightly distorted because that is just the nature of a group. You get what I'm saying? That is just the nature of a group. It has to stay it has to color within the line. Ultimately, not to shit on any group, if you go through a group, you eventually should get to a point where you could be self-studied. That's what anything should be eventually leading to. The problem is because we are so stuck in a group, we can't go beyond the group. You get what I'm saying? It's not bad to be in a group setting or a group foundation if that's your foundation. You get what I'm saying? You know, if that same foundation, that same group may also be the something that may lock you down. You get what I'm saying? It's something that could lock you down if you're not careful. All right, let's see. Externally, the universal self is covered by Maha Maya, Great Maya. Internally, Maya appears as these 24 limitations. The first step in tantric spirituality is to work on the individual scale to uncover the ego and make her reunite with Shiva, the true self. Numerology-wise, 24 means 2, 4, 6, 6 chakras, 6 energy centers. The 6 chakras are also manifestation of the 24 limitations, which means only when you go beyond the chakras do you go beyond its limitations. So when you get into that 7th chakra, the crown, which is outside of the body, you go beyond the limitations of man. You get what I'm saying? So, which is yet another understanding of going past humanity, going past the great illusion, which is the body itself, to reunite with the Shiva, which is the true, which is your true consciousness. Let me see. After the 3 coverings are removed from Kundalini, your perception will become quite different. Once you pass through the veil of this 3rd dimension, my perspective became quite different on how I view, interpret the world, how I interpret black people, if you will, how I deal and work with everything in existence, because I've seen a different perspective of life. And is something that you can feel, can acquire yourself, and it's nothing that can be debated or even explained. You just have to see it to believe it. And it's a detailed look inside yourself, because that's the veil that you're piercing. You're piercing 3 layers within yourself. Mind, you can look at mind, body, and soul, or whatever, or you can name it whatever symbolic name you want to name it, but it's 3 levels within yourself, 3 levels of the veil, 3 stages of nothingness, 3rd dimension, whatever you want to call it. And how you see yourself, not just in this world, but in as an existing being and everyone around you, the perspective changes. Now, I would say what people would notice is you're a little bit more lighthearted. Now, you know, there's people, how could you be so funny? How do you laugh so much? I'm like, because I've seen our victory already. You understand what I'm saying? I know exactly. We have nothing to worry about.
Mm-hmm.
I can laugh all day. There's nothing that's coming that's in the least bit scary to us. It's all about love.
Yeah.
Exactly. We're not talking about fake love. We're talking about real love. We're not talking about Hotep Queen, brother, you're so cool. We're talking about, no, what's in you is so divine.
Mm-hmm.
So divine. I can't hardly look or speak to it without being blubbery, without awe of what you truly are.
And I'm even in more awe of what we've truly become as fucking humans. Fucking fans of Nicki Minaj. That's just as awe-inspiring as what it is you compared to what it is you truly are. I've seen that. You get what I'm saying? We have nothing to worry about. We need to laugh more. We need to laugh more. We need to joke more. We need not to take ourselves so fucking serious.
Yes, sir.
Goddamn time. Because what you will find is we are it. There's nothing outside of us that threatens us. We're under a perceived threat based upon illusion. Because when you wake up to reality, you'll find there is no Illuminati. There is no vaccines. There is no chemtrails. There is no guy named Trayvon who's suffering. Now, you don't get to tell me you fucking not scared of death, and then when one somebody dies, you get to tell me what a tragedy it is. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Trayvon's one lucky motherfucker compared to your ass, your gas bill paying ass. You get what I'm saying? So we need to get it. We need to really talk this. We need to walk this shit like we keep talking this shit. You get what I'm saying? We need to stop, you know, making spirituality convenient for whatever cause. You know, this shit is bad when it doesn't work out, but it's good when it works out in your favor. It's spiritual when it works out in your favor. But when it's not working in your favor, there must be a demon some fucking way or some shit. Or the same shit you used to do in Christianity. Shit works out great. God is good. Shit works out bad. God works in mysterious ways. You know what I'm saying? Just whatever side, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like Jesus is helping you with your broken leg. Well, who the fuck broke my leg? You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
How did my leg get broke? You know what I'm saying? Who broke my shit? You know what I'm saying? Jesus is helping fix it. Who the fuck broke it? So it's like we doing that same shit with spirituality. You know what I'm saying? Whatever shit is going, however shit is going, we picking that side. You know? Oh, I ain't scared to die. I'm ready to die. Oh, what they did to Trayvon? Look what they did to that little. He had all that life ahead of him. You know what I'm saying? I hate rap music. Jay-Z's album is popping, son. Rap music ain't like the 90s. But Jay-Z's album, that shit is doing it, son. That nigga's crazy. That nigga's ill with it. Come on, man. Pick a side. You know what I'm saying? You went absolutely hotep crazy. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Hotep crazy. And, you know, all of that is based upon there's no real goal. You know what I'm saying? There's no real understanding of what it is they're going for. They're just going for shit to say and things to be up on socially. If everyone saw my kundalini to the left, you want to just make sure you're talking about the same shit. You talking about kundalini to the right snake, you talking about the right snake too. You know what I'm saying? Not having no real understanding what none of that means, just because he's talking about it, you're talking about it. You know what I'm saying? And that's not a path to consciousness. I know you want to be conscious. You wouldn't be hanging around. So let's do it for real. Let's do it for real. So again, panicpack@hotmail.com. Get your herb packs. That's Herbs of the Pineal. All that Kundalini experience. You want to go to drleanbay.com to get his chakra stones. My girl Tiffany, you want to email me for her info so you can at least see what she got, or you, especially all you ladies with the babies and that little sexy woman shit. I mean, this shit is off the hook. I've seen that knit shit. It look all bulky, but she ain't got it like that. It should look like real shit. Her hat is crazy. You know what I'm saying? Crazy. So give me her email. She told me it's TiffanyMessenger@yahoo.com. TiffanyMessenger@yahoo.com. But if not, if you can't get her there, just email me at panicpack@hotmail.com. I'll give you her info. And Oregon, you need to get with Jerry Miller. Like I said, if you don't have a Facebook, I'll make sure you get his email and or whatever else you need.
to get in contact with him. And, you know what I'm saying, we'll be back next Wednesday night, Science Night. And, you know, I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you got something out of this. We'll do the question and answers next week.
No doubt about it. All right.
Yeah.
You had to give it up for Brother Panic.
Yes, sir.
He dropped it on y'all tonight on the Kundalini.
Yes, indeed.
The Awakening. And also, let's talk about a technique before we get up off of here so that they can definitely try out. I know I can give one as far as awakening the Shakti and the Eden of Bengala, so that the Kundalini can raise up through the Shoshuna. Basically, there's a technique in which that you you sit with your back straight, and as you breathe in for a count of six, and then you take two sniffs. After you breathe in for a count of six, and then you hold it and bend forward at about a 45-degree angle. Hold your breath for 12 seconds. And then as you lean back, coming back to your original position, you make a buzzing noise like a bee. That particular technique awakens the Eden of Bengala and the Shakti in order to raise that Kundalini up through the Shoshuna. So you definitely want to leave y'all with that. Practice that 6-12-6. Once again, that's 6-12-6. Before we go.
Oh, brother, I enjoyed Brother Panic tonight, as always.
Yeah, good, sir.
That science on me. I sure appreciate you more.
Good, good. Yes, sir. We'd
do
like
it again
help.
Next Wednesday night.
Yes, sir. Okay. Here's a little technique. My thing was more visualization. Very powerful, because remember, you're trying to meet that Shakti. So when you're in the tub, you got to get some Tiger Balm. You can get Tiger Balm from your drugstore. You want the maximum formula. Put a dot on your forehead while you meditate in that water. But, you know, it's all about visualization. I won't tell you the visualization, but, you know, there's visualization. You see white light or whatever light, or, you know what I mean? You're going to have to read some about your little chakras or whatever. So white light or whatever light, you know, coming down to your chakra, all the way down to your base chakra, then you bring it back up to the pineal, and you'll feel it radiating with that Tiger Balm. Tiger Balm is like Bengay. It's that type of thing. But Tiger Balm has real menthol in it. The other shit has shit that just gets your skin hot. The Tiger Balm actually penetrates. It's the Chinese one. And so it's one of the best, you know, to have. And you put that on, with some of the breathing. I'm not big into the breathing, but Aleem will tell you mad breathing technique or the one he just told you. And what happens is you'll start to feel your pineal start to pulse. And it'll actually awake to be able to receive that light, that Kundalini, because that's the Shiva, you know, that's the Shiva energy. And, of course, always the herb pack, you know, it helps in that area. But like I said, Tiger Balm is something. If you don't want to get an herb pack or you know what I mean, you don't feel like waiting for an herb pack or whatever, Tiger Balm is something that'll do it. Well, so that's usually a pretty good one that used to work for me.
All
right.
Yeah, but visualization was always the key.
Right.
All right.
Yeah, sure. Visualization was always the key. So we'll be back next Wednesday on Science Night.
First World Order Radio. Finally, we are on the air. No doubt.
All right. There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about
what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Preceding levels in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Preceding levels in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theory.